starting your journey to financial freedom.
Now.
You're listening to the New Investor Podcast.
This is the Young Investor for the New Investor Podcast, and it is the Saturday Debrief Episode 1, a brand new series I would like to implement in order to go through the week, the moves we may have made in order to get closer to our financial objectives and so on. Now, it's been also the 39th day on our journey towards financial freedom, and since these last 39 days, my investment account value grew by 22.8%. And it was all very simple and came down to me making only two operations. One, I saved 68% of my salary. Two, I reinvested 90% of my yearly bonus. Please do refer to the episode focusing on how to grow your income to understand more about why I have done so. The remaining increase came from the healthy start of the year on the stock market. And also, I did not buy or sell any of my stocks since then. I did not panic. I did not give in to my emotions when the markets opened on the negative. I did not follow any advice but my own. I was in no hurry. I remained confident by my initial choices of companies and the prices I purchased them for. I started to build up cash in the event of a market meltdown and will continue to do so. I did not over-diversify by going around buying up companies I do not identify myself with or highly engage myself with. Same goes for the sectors they evolve into. I restricted my investment into dividend growth stocks only. What I am about to say is, however, extremely important. Regardless of your current gains, you need to be psychologically prepared to potentially lose it all in a few days while being totally unfazed by such an event. As Warren Buffett, the legendary investor, said, bad news is the investor's best friend. That will probably mean the cash you have diligently built up will come in very handy. A real buying power while wonderful companies are on a discount should such an event happen. In my personal view, feeling and opinion, should you be starting your investment journey today? The market has been on a steady growth since the beginning of the year and might be a little bit expensive at the moment. However, I have not scouted the whole market, nor have I been going into the details of hundreds of companies. I am talking about my own sector and companies. If you are into, let's say, biotech, and you're interested in that sector, and instinctively you follow the news on what is being done at that level, read articles on your free time, then you are probably a fan of biotech, and you should then look into all the players in the sector and form your own opinion. Again, this is research, but given it is another passion of yours, it should be fun, and then you'll do it in an amazing way, getting closer to these companies and end up probably investing in them. So this is the approach. You do not have the resources that investment firms have to look at every single company across multiple sectors. And as Julius Caesar, the legendary Roman emperor, said, I'd rather be first in a village than second in Rome. Given that what he accomplished, his advice, believe me, is very valid. If the market is at an all-time high, as it is today, I would start by putting a solid saving plan and budget in place as to focus on freeing up future investment money. Make a yearly budget. Know exactly what you can spend and how much you can invest. That way, you will also see your yearly objective very clearly. This will be your goal for the year. On this one, Given that we live in a society wanting everything to happen immediately, you will feel that your first year goal may be insignificant compared to what you would need to achieve your dreams. I have important news for you. Your plan must be a 10-year plan. If you do not have what it takes to be patient, diligent, disciplined, and passionate about your own future success, I have just given you some precious information. I have just identified the root of your problem. In this case, it is a question of mindset, and that can be changed practically immediately. You are in full control. I will share with you my current feelings about my present financial situation. I only have the macro in mind, not what I have achieved so far. We are talking about financial freedom here, and that has different degrees for different people. For me, I have the past decade of being a full-on consumer to rectify. So skies is the limit for me. That keeps me fired up while being fully aware of my achievements so far, which I consider as victories. Have you started your journey already? If so, I would love to hear from you and your achievements to share here. Get in touch via thenewinvestorpod.com, thenewinvestorpod.com, and I will be pleased to get in touch with you for an interview that we could share on that podcast. I wish you all a fantastic weekend, 2 full days in your week when you can fully focus on yourself and your own continuous improvement. That's great. Enjoy it.